Look, I've been a techie guy my entire life, but every now and then, even I come across some tech tips that completely changed the game for me and helped me be more productive. In this video, I'll be showing you 5 tech tips that I wish I knew myself 5 years ago. Hi there, Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. My name is Maneetpaul Singh, and on this channel, we talk about all the different ways we can use technology as a tool to live a more productive life. Whether so we get more work done or just so we can optimize our existing workflows, every single week, we'll be talking about different ways we can use tech to achieve these goals. Now, the first tip that I want to show you is something I literally learned just a few weeks ago, and I can't believe I lived my entire life without knowing this tip. We all know the power of keyboard shortcuts. Things like Command C, Command V for copy and paste, but there are a few more shortcuts out there that are just as simple and just as impactful to our everyday workflow. Let me actually show you this tip in action. Say you're typing an email and you want to delete the last few words that you wrote. What I would normally do is just press the delete key multiple times and do it that way. But if you want to shortcut this, all you have to do is hold the option key and then press delete, and then you'll be deleting one word at a time, which is obviously a lot faster to go back. Let's take this one step farther though. Let's say you're in the middle of a sentence and you want to delete the word to the right of your cursor. If you hold the FN key and then the option key and then press delete, it'll delete to the right instead of the left. So you can delete backwards, which is also extremely useful, especially when you're typing large documents. I know it sounds a bit ridiculous being so hype about keyboard shortcuts, but things like this really make a big difference because they compound every single time we use them to save time. Imagine how much time we'd be spending in our lives if we actually right-clicked for copy and paste every single time we wanted to use that. These option and FN keyboard shortcuts are just as impactful, and I believe it'll make just as big of an impact in my life as I use them to type my documents. Now, this next tip is along very similar lines for keyboard shortcuts and typing. Say you want to copy and paste text from one application to another. If you've done this in the past, you know that sometimes the font size, the font color, and all this extra stuff comes over with the text that you don't really want. There's actually a really easy way to do this. Let's say we're in Sticky to the Max over here, and I want to copy and paste the translation for this Shabbat Bhakti over here. I'm going to press Command C, go to this Google Doc, and rather than pressing Command V, I'm going to press Command Shift V, and that will copy and paste just the text. Just to illustrate the example over here, I'll just do Command V without the shift now, and you'll see how it looks and you can compare the difference. Also, if you ever forget this keyboard shortcut, an easy way to remember is simply right clicking and hitting the paste without formatting button over here, which will also show you the shortcut right there. This next tech tip is for Zoom meetings. Right now, a lot of us are working at home full time and we use Zoom for all of our work. And if you're on Zoom calls all the time, you're probably like me and like to keep yourself on mute unless you absolutely have to talk. The last thing you want to do is have unwanted audio going into the Zoom meeting with all your coworkers. An easy way to accomplish this without having to press the mute button every single time is going into your settings for Zoom and the preferences. Under the audio section at the very bottom, there's a section over here for pressing and holding the space key to temporarily unmute. And when you do this, rather than having to press the microphone at the bottom left to mute and unmute yourself, all you have to do is press and hold the space bar, and that will automatically unmute you while you're holding the space bar key. The second you let go, you're back on mute. This next tip has really changed my life in making sure I stay on top of all those little things that you always forget to do every once in a while. Things like watering the plants, washing your bed sheets, whatever it might be, there's always those things that we have to do at a random schedule that isn't every day. This tip will make sure you always remember how to do it. And the best way to activate this tip is actually not on the computer, but on your phone. If you have an iPhone and use Siri, you can tell Siri to remind you to do things at random intervals. Let me give you an example. Siri, can you make sure that you remind me to water the plants every 10 days? Siri, remind me to wash my bed sheets every 2 weeks. It's that easy. You can do this for every single thing that you have on your mind, whether it's watering the plants, making your budget on your computer, having that automated reminder come up on my phone and on my computer every 2 weeks, every 10 days, whatever it might be. It just makes life that much easier. This next tech tip has made me so much more focused while working on my computer. If you're like me, you're in the middle of a meeting or you're doing some work, then all of a sudden you get some text messages or some random notification comes up on the screen, and then all of a sudden you get so distracted and you just completely go off the rails with your work. This tip will help alleviate that. On your Mac, if you go to the top menu bar over here and press the control center icon, you're gonna see a button here for do not disturb. And this will actually work just the same way it does on your phone. I can click on the button and I can actually even choose the interval I wanna use for 1 hour, until this evening, or even until tomorrow. This will make sure that you don't get bothered by any notifications while you're working on your computer. It actually makes a very, very big difference. And the fact that this feature is so accessible right in the menu bar, I am literally using this feature every single day. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, check out my tech tips playlist. It'll be on the screen somewhere right now. I plan on making many more of these types of videos so you can binge watch all these random tips. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.